What's up, guys? Your Ace Hybrids here. Shout out to my ninja Aki Noichis. And last time, we react to different types of memories that and clips that X, that was going on with X. And this is actually the story of Jocelyn Flores, which I always wanted to know. So, without further ado, man, let's get right into the video.
Jocelyn Flores was a 16-year-old girl.
So, one thing is, I'm
going to
watch the whole thing.
Her father
and
died
just
from an illness her family could not afford to treat when she was
gonna
only
be too
four.
Long to,
and not long after, she would come
things.
Out telling her family
it,
that her relative had molested her.
Hold on.
Jocelyn, who had battled.
Right, and when I do stop it, I'm going to make sure I keep it brief.
Not long after, she would come out telling her family that her relative had molested her. Jocelyn, who had battled with depression and had at one point told police that her head was just messed up and that doctors couldn't do anything for her, was also described as having an obsession with suicide. Jocelyn's aunt would later tell a story about how teachers in Jocelyn's elementary school would evaluate students' behavior with a traffic spotlight, where green meant good, yellow meant alright, and red meant bad. Jocelyn would always say, "I try so hard to get a green light, but I always get a red.
Man,
I don't even get yellow,
school?
I always get red." Her aunt would also later say that Jocelyn wanted to go out with her friends, wear makeup, flirt with boys, and have a drink. Her family, to state it simply, did not want her to do those things. This was because Jocelyn's mother was known to be a devout Christian, and her family was actually quite religious. One day, when Jocelyn was working with her uncle, she snuck away with another employee. And she told her aunt later, when she got in trouble for it, "I'm going to kill myself." At this time, her family didn't really take it seriously, and they thought she was just being a young teenage girl.
This is the thing about a Christian, right? Some people got it messed up to where they're trying to stop people from doing anything that's wrong, period. What it is to be a devoted Christian is to follow the word of God, to do the best that you can, because nobody's perfect. Repent of whatever sins that you have done, but also tell other people on His word what you can do right and, you know, what's wrong. But you're not just supposed to push it onto people to where they have to live by it, because that's their choice. At the end of the day, there's people that they're going to make mistakes throughout everything, even when it comes to other, you know, adults and just kids. It's going to happen, but you just have to keep reminding them that, you know, God's there to love you. Whatever is going on, we're here for you. You know, there's still an avenue. You're not locked up in a cage. You're not subjected to this one spot. And I think that's where you know, certain families got it messed up and wrong when it comes to being a Christian.
But little did they know that she was quite serious. Jocelyn would end up being hospitalized 4 times after this for taking pills, cutting her wrists, drinking bleach, and then doing all 3. Later, when her family finally realized she was serious, they took her to a therapist, and the therapist said that she needed to try new things, such as going to concerts and really letting her explore more. So her family started letting her wear makeup and everything that they weren't doing before. X ended up flying down Jocelyn and another person he met on Instagram, and X claimed that this was for modeling, but many people seem to believe that there was a bit more romance to it than that. Jocelyn allegedly had a problem with the other girl, most likely due to them both having some type of jealousy because of their interest in X. One of the days where both of them were at X's house, he ended up going to prom with his cousin, but realized when he returned that about $7,000
was missing. That's a lot of money.
When he had confronted the girls about it, they blamed each other and explained that the other girl was saying things behind X's back about him, and this escalated into them wanting to fight each other. With X being fresh off of probation and not wanting anything to affect his future, he informed the girls that they would have to leave without modeling for the clothing brand and offered to pay for their flights back, which Jocelyn immediately rejected. Although she did text him shortly after, asking if she was really not going to be allowed to stay with him, and X did confirm that this was the case. Their last text appeared to have been around 10:35 p.m.
So they had like the...
At 11 p.m. on May 13th, 2017,
they must have
the same day and the day before Mother's Day, Jocelyn and 2 men thought to be X's security or friends checked into a Hampton Inn. These 2 men were meant to watch over Jocelyn, but they ended up leaving to go get some food, and after 30 minutes, one of them returned. They attempted to use the bathroom, but the light was on and the door was locked, and he ended up just leaving to go with his friends.
No.
He came back another 45 minutes later, but it was still locked, and the light was still on. After coming back from smoking, he just decided to go to sleep, and it wasn't until 6 hours later that that same person woke up and decided to call hotel staff for help. And not long after, it was confirmed that Jocelyn Flores had committed suicide. When the police contacted her mother to inform her, Jocelyn's mother didn't have much to say. The aunt and uncle would actually later return a call to the police, stating that her mother wouldn't accept any more calls from the police, and that the aunt and uncle would become the family contacts. This may have something to do with the parents being very religious and the death being a suicide. X released a song 5 days later after her death titled Garrett's Revenge, named after his friend Garrett, who had the clothing line that had been working with X on some clothing designs. Dedicated the song to Jocelyn and used her suicide note as
the artwork. So she left a suicide note?
Some of it blurred out.
I've come to praise for us, my dear. Can't pretend that I was perfect, leaving you in fear. Oh man, what a world of things I hear. If I could act on my revenge, no way.
Garrett would later go on to say that he had met Jocelyn, but only talked to her a couple times and didn't really feel like he knew her, but was certainly impacted by the death. And 2 days later, X would go on Instagram Live and what he described as a serious live stream, and here's what he had to say.
So a couple of days ago, I basically went through something that I've went through before, but not exactly in this terms. Like, I've had friends that killed him. She flew down here. She in a way unexplained. She killed herself when she came down here, and I mean, it was a devastating situation to deal with. I basically got on here today to kind of address her and her family. Because I haven't been able to obviously contact her family personally, I'm basically on here to pay my condolences. I mean, it fucked me up so bad to where I wasn't in the social media for the last few days unless I was addressing something that I needed to. Her name was Jocelyn. I'm at a loss of words for the situation, in all honesty. I just really want to. It's hard to kind of even remotely have words for the situation. I step away from it and see it happen right next to you and feel useless. You know, I felt powerless. And
it's crazy. It's just how, like, he's trying to explain something that's so serious, and you just got people that's on here that really don't care. And it's like, to an extent, I get it, because it didn't happen to you, it wasn't around you. People have different mindsets, people don't care because they're on a live with X, but it's like, man, it's so hard being a celebrity, if you really think about it.
It's just overall a really, 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 really sad situation. Obviously, it wasn't in the media, so I'm addressing it myself personally, because I feel like that's necessary as respect to her and her family. My condolences to her family. If her family would like to speak to me, by all means, contact me via email. However, I got to get in contact with her mother or her stepfather or anyone in her family. I am 100% willing to speak to you. My condolences.
After allegedly attempting multiple times to contact X, Jocelyn's aunt would say, "We just wanted to know what her last day was like. That torments me. I just wanted to know the last day. Please, tell me anything. What did she do that day? What did she eat? When was the last time you saw her? Did you take her to Universal Studios like you promised her? What is it that you did with her? What was her last day like? That's all I asked." She considered crashing a concert to confront X before it was big, but ended up deciding against it. 3 months later, X would finally release Jocelyn Flores, which used a Potsu instrumental with a Shiloh Dynasty sample.
I'm in pain, wanna put 10 shots in my brain. I've been tripping about some things, can't change. Switch on the same time, I'm tame, put your diss in, begging a phone call. Girl that you fought with, kill herself. That was this summer and nobody helped. And ever since then, when I hate myself, wanna fucking end it, pessimistic.
This immediately blew up and would maintain the top spot on charts for 20 weeks
just
straight.
Just hearing that gives me a whole new outlook to that song now. It hits me in a whole new way.
and this brought a lot of attention to the previously quiet case. When Jocelyn's uncle first heard this, he was very surprised. Some of her family members were angry with X for not getting permission, while others felt honored, with her stepsister even going out of her way to thank X on her YouTube account. Of course, Jocelyn's aunt did not have the same reaction. She cursed out X on Facebook, later saying, "It's a constant reminder. It's like I'm doing okay and then someone tags me on some X story or likes my picture and mentions X, reminding me that she's gone." Other family members later stated that the problem they had with the song was that it wasn't accurate and that they didn't know the story of Jocelyn. Because between depressive episodes and sometimes during them, Jocelyn was funny, outgoing, girly, and extremely stubborn. Although the aunt only said she was a handful. She was always a handful. In the clip I'm about to play, this is just an example of X talking about suicide, which he would often do after the situation, and often try to help his fans with multiple situations that were going on within their lives.
And it's very important that, kids, if you're on medication, and you have bipolar disorder or any sort of mental disorder, it's very important that you take your medication.
This is one thing that people don't understand, why X was so loved after this. Because when it came to this, he was always reaching out for people that need to help, and he was genuine with it. You know what I mean? He wasn't like getting on live, saying something, then doing something else the next day. Like, he was consistent on what he was doing with his fans, and he actually really cared.
You're out of your comfort zone, and it's very important that you do what you have to do, because in this situation, her being down here, I had no idea that she wasn't on her medication and that she wasn't basically going through the procedure that she needed to. And it's very unfortunate for this to have gone that far, for this girl to kill herself. And I don't know what signs were showed before. I didn't see it. In all honesty, I did not see it coming.
After this incident, X did put out the album 17, which had a pretty great response to it, and later would even put out the Question Mark album, which also was his best album up until that point, and was the most success X had ever seen. It seemed as though he was on a much better path. He stopped getting in drama with many of his other rap acquaintances, and also seemed to advocate a lot about helping his fans' mental health, challenges to help people, and really having a lot of just good fan interactions. And then...
oh, man.
Developing right now, a search for a killer in South Florida after an up-and-coming rapper is shot dead. 20-year-old XXXTentacion killed in an apparent robbery. Police say the artist, whose real name is Jose Onfroy, was leaving a Broward County motorcycle shop yesterday when he was shot by two men who ran up to his car. He was rushed to a hospital but did not make it. Onfroy's death comes just weeks after he earned his first number one album, which debuted March 31st.
After X died, the aunt said that she felt as though it was a good example of karma and felt as though he played a part in Jocelyn's suicide and used her death to promote his music. During this time, countless amounts of posts had been made in memory of X using the song in the background. Although the aunt did say after a while, one Instagram account did catch her attention that would post daily with unseen pictures of Jocelyn and an occasional picture of X. This account later would become much bigger and help many people who were unhappy after X's death get past their mental state and feel better. The aunt said that this did make her feel better about the situation, and when the account user was contacted, she claimed that she had heard of X through his song, Jocelyn Flores. That's pretty much the end of the story, so if you did enjoy... Jocelyn Flores was a 16-year-old girl from the Bronx. Her father died from an illness her family could not afford to treat when she was only 4. And not long after, she would come out telling her family that her relative...
When it comes to death, suicide, and all that, man, it's something that hits me in a different way and I can understand. Because I've struggled so much with that. I wanted to do that so much when I was little. Because of how I lived, because what was going on, because of people at school, because of mostly of my mom, and that's where like I started making music, and my hate and depression was like my fuel to everything, and it still is, and it sucks that it's that way. And I'm trying to break out of that, you know, and also dealing with this. My dad passed when I was 4, due to some people. And with this, I just gotta say, you know, just be, try to be as happy as you can. Try to find a way through the madness. Try to find a path on where you can oversee things and fix them, because it's not easy and it's not going to get easy until you get better within yourself. So that's literally my message from what's going on from here, and just what I've witnessed, even when it comes to certain friends and people that I know, that I knew, that committed suicide. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Please stay safe, and if you are in any type of negative mindset, please hit me up. You know, my Instagram, my Twitter, email, it's all down there. You can hit me up, no problem. If you need help, I will, you know, communicate with you. I will talk to you, you know, because I know how that feels. I know how it feels when you feel like nobody's going to listen to you, or nobody's there for you, even though they say they are, and then they switch up, and then, you know, I've been through everything when it comes to that. So again, if you guys need help, just hit me up. Please just ask. Just ask for my help or anybody's help that's near you. Regardless, I got you. Alright? You know, because I'm not having a lot of messages come through because I have been slacking on the consistency. But take advantage of me while you can. Because when we get to a certain extent of this, I know it's going to be harder for me to talk to you guys. But I'd rather talk to as much as you guys as I can. You know? I'll see you guys in the next one.
Slide, let the power slide, getting consistent mass genocide, a milkshake, plenty of cups, never enough, have a blunt.